You know what we haven't talked about in a little while? My roller skates, Skate-ageddon. If you don't know, back in like the beginning of quarantine, I ordered a pair only to be totally scammed and I never even got them. I actually had to file a claim with my bank and everything. And since I live in Phoenix, Arizona, by the time I was done dealing with all that stuff and trying to order another pair from somewhere else, it was already hotter than hell's kitchen here. So I just had to tell you that my skating dreams are not over. They are going to happen as soon as it cools down here later this fall. And then you will get beautimous content like this. Today on the show, Sarah Jessica Parker is calling out the left, even though she's on the left. Forget Cuties, there is a new disgusting show that you need to know about that is 10 times worse. Black Lives Matter is actually working overtime to hide what they're really about, and so much more with Hot Take Tuesday. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. Carrie Bradshaw has officially had it with NYC's leftist buffoon mayor, Bill de Blasio. And as I stepped outside to see a man taking dump in the street and another old lady getting mugged, I wondered, is de Blasio running New York? Or is New York running de Blasio? SJP and dozens of other top New York City business executives sent a letter to Governor Cuomo and Mayor Bill de Blasio asking for them to buck up and make a better plan for New Yorkers after their quality of life has plummeted during the pandemic. But Sarah, what do you expect if you're going to keep voting for leftists?
If one more person asks me that today.
If the biggest advocates for leftism are saying it's bad, then you know you screwed the pooch on governing. Remember when the body positivity movement first started, how quickly it spiraled into, you better accept and celebrate morbid obesity because it's too mean to tell people they're unhealthy?
Well, it all comes from eating too much.
Well, now it's morphed into children need to see adults naked so they know what to expect later in life.
I've heard enough. This is insane.
Oh, we're just getting started, Mr. Shu. People are so afraid of being labeled far right or non-inclusive, they're greenlighting movies and TV shows that are straight up grooming young kids. We just went through the Cuties debacle, but now there's a Danish show that puts 11 to 13 year olds in a room with naked adults for educational purposes to counter body shaming.
Kom ind for voksne, Emilie, Martin B, Bob, Ulla og Martin B.
Don't you love how the producers and network felt the need to censor the adults' bodies for the audiences at home, but it was okay for the children in the room?
Has the planet gone mad?
You know that the next step is going to be to let our young kids watch porn in school because it's for educational purposes and they need to see it to understand for later, right?
Mark my words.
The reason the goalposts keep changing is because we're living in a world that has rejected God over and over again, all while championing subjective truth over definitive standards of what is right and what is wrong. This makes it impossible to conclusively distinguish good from evil.
Fact is, the whole good versus evil balancing the scales thing, I'm over it.
It's the blatantly accepted pedophilia for me.
Do you like teenage girls?
When you say teenage, how are we talking?
Last week, we posted about the Marxist agenda of the Black Lives Matter organization and how this ideology was written plain as day on their website for all to see. You do know what Marxism is, right?
Why don't you explain this to me like I'm five?
Okay, quick politic. Marxism is a political ideology for how the government should run, founded by a German philosopher dude named Karl Marx, hence the name Marxism. It's this belief that humans are prevented from achieving in life due to hierarchies of oppression, and that the only way to achieve prosperity on Earth is for every individual to strip their possessions that keep them in power. They believe that otherwise, the groups that are richer than you will always be trying to oppress you and keep you controlled. This is bad because Marxists believe that the only way to prevent one group from exploiting another is for the government to step in and have full control of everything. Money, property, and resources. And we all remember what happens when you allow the government to get bigger. It sucks. Simply put, you lose your rights, your properties, and your freedoms.
Now, sing.
Black Black Lives Matter, Inc. is a Marxist organization, and that isn't a made-up rumor from crazy conservatives, okay? The two co-founders have said that they were in interviews, and they had Marxist beliefs written all over their website until a few days ago. While you were scrolling through people's Instagram stories, they were scrubbing their entire website. Now they can just claim that it was all made up, history rewritten, they'll deny everything, and we'll look crazy, so that's fun. Once again, George Orwell's 1984 predicted all of this. Good thing we live in the age of technology, though, and there are always screenshots.
Just forget I ever said anything.
Producer Abigail, it's Tuesday, so you know what that means. It's Hot Take time.
Hot Take Tuesday.
A research team in Portugal is claiming that social distancing might actually make you more likely to catch coronavirus. Basically, they're saying that it's weakening our immune systems. They're not saying that we need to stop social distancing just yet, just that it should be looked into and studied in case it does turn out to be hurting us.
If we find out that the reaction to this was completely overblown, that people's lives were turned upside down for no reason, the minuscule amount of trust that does still exist for the media will be completely evaporated. Every time we've ever given government or mainstream media the benefit of the doubt should be thrown out of the window. There will be a massive rise in alternative news like podcasting and citizen journalists. Shoot, there already is. If you ever wanted to start a YouTube channel or a podcast, start preparing now.
But as your friend, I say you gotta do it. This is your moment.
Cardi B says that she hasn't shed one tear since filing for divorce and that she isn't leaving Offset because of his cheating. She says she's leaving him because she's sick of arguing. She said, I got tired of not seeing things eye to eye.
Haven't we all been there? You're fighting so much that you're just exhausted emotionally. Like, I can't stand to text one more paragraph or have one more screaming match on the phone cut into my beauty sleep. Thank you, next.
The streaming platform DC Universe is going to change its name to DC Universe Infinite and become a comics-only platform. The shows that are currently on there will be moved to HBO Max.
I've never read a comic book in my life, but I am happy for the superhero people, I think. Unless the superhero conservatives hate this, then I hate it for you.
I don't know if it's art, but I like it.
NASA confirmed that Estee Lauder is filming an ad campaign from space, and they're going to be sending up 10 bottles of their night repair serum. This all comes after the president encouraged NASA to help find ways to stimulate the economy.
Dude, if there are aliens walking around with better skin than me, I am joining the Space Force for revenge, and I am taking those suckers out.
Pretty smooth cinnamon skin.
According to new polling, the majority of both conservatives and liberals say that they wouldn't mind their kids ending up marrying someone who has opposite political views.
I guess I'm in the minority then, because I definitely would care. How are you gonna raise kids with someone that has completely different worldviews than you? It's a recipe for disaster, in my opinion. I mean, what about you? Would you care?
Bad idea. This is a bad idea.
Last and most important, POPlitics has tried covering this hot take a couple weeks ago, but while writing it, I was censored and prohibited from talking about it. So I may lose my job for this, but I'm risking it for you, CUTEservatives.
It's gonna be a dangerous mission and I might not make it back.
Pop culture news host and diva of the Valley of Phoenix, Alex Clark, is rumored to have a new boyfriend who is an Arizona native. That's all we know. They held hands once.
I plead the fifth.
Hey, where's my lawyer?
You're upsetting my client.
Hey, little doggies, don't you know you can listen to the show on your stereo?
Oh my God, this is my jam, girl.
Go subscribe to us on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, iHeartRadio, TuneIn, and almost any other podcast platform. Leave us a 5-star review to beat all the other leftist pop culture shows. Please do me a big favor and like this episode before you exit out. I would like to hear what you think about that Danish TV show, because if you scroll through the comments on the New York Times Instagram post about it, it is almost all positive and people saying stuff like, we need this in America. And if you're new here, it helps us out immensely if you share POPlitics on your story, so please do that right now. We're back tomorrow at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. It's pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. Click below to watch yesterday's episode. Please subscribe, thumbs up, share this video, and ring the bell for notifications so you never miss the conservative. And make sure you're following this show at POPlitics on Instagram for even more CUTEservative content.